So you can go to her website or contact her, ask me if you don't have her contact, if you're interested in doing a class on mindfulness-based stress reduction. So that's that. Find a comfortable seat on your bed. And close your eyes. Take a moment allowing yourself to shift around, feeling for a comfortable seat here. Rooting down intentionally through your sit bones, and then lengthening up through the crown of your head. Soften through your shoulders so there's a release through the neck and the upper back. And then fill all of that space up with your breath. Intentionally drawing the breath in, using the muscles in the back of your throat. And intentionally emptying yourself out, feeling that place at the bottom of the exhale where you connect back into your core. Place your hands down on your belly and or your low back. Start to breathe so that you can feel that expansion. So with the inhale, you feel the belly and the low back press outward. And with the exhale, you feel that connection back to your center, that drawing back into your core. And bring your hands up to your rib cage. You can have hands on the same side, or cross over, this time expanding the breath outward to the left and the right, so you feel the ribs press into the palms of your hands, expanding outward with the inhale, contracting with the exhale. And bring your hands up to your heart and or your upper back. Shifting your breath here so you feel the breath lift the chest, expand through the shoulder blades. With the exhale, you feel it settling back in, connecting back into your core. Shifting into Viloma, this three-part breath. So place your hands in any of those areas or any combo of those areas that feels good to you in this moment. Exhale all the air out. Inhale the first third into the belly and low back. Pause. Second third, inhale into the rib cage. Pause. Final third, feel yourself all the way up, lifting through the chest, the heart center, the upper back, hold full at the top. As you're ready, exhale smoothly, emptying chest, ribs, belly, all the way to empty. Again, like that. First third into the belly and low back. Pause. Second third, fill up the rib cage. Pause. Final third, chest, upper back, all the way to full. And exhale, empty chest, ribs, belly. Do that twice more at your own pace. Once you finish that final round, come back. dedicate this practice to what bubbles up for you. Maybe it's simply to just be with yourself. Maybe it's to go slow, easy. Maybe it's to push yourself and feel strong. Maybe it's more emotional. So three more breaths, establishing what you need this morning, dedicating your practice to that. As you feel ready, release your hands and just start to move here in your seat, maybe twisting a little side to side, maybe taking some seated cat-cows or rolling to the neck and shoulders. Any place that feels a little stuck, trying to start working that out this morning. And every movement, every time we shift in our class, keeping in mind that intention, that dedication to what you need this morning, keeping in that in mind as you shift and move. Your next inhale, rock forward, coming to hands and knees. And we'll just continue this exploratory movement. So it could be all the way back to child's pose, and just hanging out here, feeling that connection to the earth, stretching out the back body. Maybe some cat-cows feels good, or figure eights. There's really no wrong way to shift your move. It's just feeling into your body, experimenting through your body this morning. And as you feel ready, shifting back to our first downward facing dog of the practice, curling toes under, hips extending to the sky. This movement feels good. Keep that going here. You can step it out. You can walk your feet wider than that width apart, shifting the hips side to side. You can press the chest forward and back. Just feeling into this initial inversion of the practice. Intentionally starting out slow this morning, so you're feeling into the body and getting in tune with what you need. Move so fast in life that sometimes we need to just focus inward and slow down. Two more breaths. Exhale, slowly lower down to your knees and come all the way onto your back with your prop nearby. Does anyone not have a prop? I'll get that. Anyone else? You good? Oh, okay. Blocks all around. Alright. Take hold of that fabulous block, or if you brought your own roll, since I haven't brought any here yet, grab your roll. Place it in between your thighs, snug up towards the pubic bone, right where it feels uncomfortable, and then float your legs straight up to the sky. Interlace the hands behind your head. Take a huge breath. Fill up the back body. Fill up your core with breath. Hold that breath in. Curl tailbone up. Squeeze around your prop. Exhale, lift head and shoulders. Shoulder blades lift. Squeeze a little more. Pull belly down. Awesome. Inhale, lower head and shoulders. Hold the breath. Press mid back into mat. Curl tailbone, squeeze. Exhale, head and shoulders lift. Shoulder blades lift. Squeeze a little more, pull belly down. Inhale, lower head and shoulders. Hold the breath. Press mid back into mat. Curl tailbone, squeeze. Exhale, lift head and shoulders. Shoulder blades come up. Squeeze a little more, pull low belly down. Inhale, lower head and shoulders. Hold the breath. Press mid back in the mat, curl tailbone, squeeze. Exhale, head and shoulders lift, Hold the breath in, curl tailbone up, squeeze. Exhale, head and shoulders lift. Squeeze a little more, pull belly down. Inhale, bring left hand to prop, straddle the legs. Exhale, curl tailbone, reach out through thighs, pull belly down. Inhale, bring legs back together, lower head and shoulders. Hold the breath, press the mid back in the mat. Curl tailbone, squeeze. Exhale, lift head and shoulders. Shoulder blades come up, squeeze a little more, pull belly down. Inhale, right hand to prop, straddle. Exhale, curl tailbone, reach out through thighs, pull belly down. Inhale, legs back together, lower head and shoulders. Hold the breath, press mid back in the mat. Curl tailbone, squeeze. Exhale, lift head and shoulders. Shoulder blades lift, squeeze a little more, pull belly down. Inhale, left hand to prop, straddle. Exhale, curl tailbone, reach out through thighs, pull belly down. Inhale, legs back together, lower head and shoulders. Hold your breath, curl tailbone, squeeze. Exhale, head and shoulder blades lift, squeeze a little more, pull belly down. Inhale, right hand to prop, straddle. Exhale, curl tailbone, reach out through thighs, pull low belly down. Inhale, bring legs back together, lower head and shoulders. One more here, curl tailbone up, squeeze. Exhale, head and shoulder blades lift, squeeze a little more, pull belly down. Inhale, hand to prop, straddle. Exhale, curl tailbone, reach out through thighs, pull belly down. Bring legs back together, lower head and shoulders. Hold the breath, curl tailbone, squeeze. Exhale, head and shoulder blades lift. Squeeze a second time, pull belly down. Inhale, right hand to prop, straddle. Exhale, curl tailbone, reach out through the inner thighs, pull belly down. Inhale, legs back together and breathe. Set your prop aside. Let's do some windshield wiper legs. So arms come out to your sides, feet about hip width apart. Exhale, knees to one side. Inhale, back through center. Exhale to the other side. Just get into a rhythm that feels good to your body. Remembering that intention of what you need, of this dedication to yourself, this make sure you have your prop in a reachable distance. Setting up for bridge pose. And you should, unless you threw your prop because you didn't want to do more core work. All right. If you're reaching down, graze the back of your heels with your fingertips. Feet are about hip width apart. On your inhale, peel the spine away from the mat, lifting into bridge. Press down through your feet, lift high through the hips. And then focus the breath into this front plane of the body, really expanding through the core, through the rib cage. Maybe closing your eyes so that attention is turned inward, tuning even more into feeling. Take hold of your prop. Place it underneath your hips, tallest height that can comfortably be placed. You want it closer down to the sit bone, so not in the small of your low back, but closer to your glutes. Keep the left foot rooted on the ground. Inhale, extend the right leg up towards the ceiling. We're gonna hang out here for a few breaths, really pressing down to the left foot, reaching out to the right, so much so that the block is barely there supporting you. So your own strength is holding you more than anything. Breathe here. Maybe you're getting a stretch. Maybe it's just the strength work. Either is fine. Then exhale, bend the right knee. Cross your ankle over the left thigh, coming into this figure four. Start to draw the right knee down and forward, breathing into this right hip. Two more full breaths here. You press that left, or that right foot rather, more into the quad and isometrically draw it forward. Sometimes you can feel a nice stretch in that left hip flexing. Inhale, re-extend the right leg to the ceiling. Exhale, slowly bring that right foot all the way back down to the mat. Good. Adjust your block if needed. Inhale, keep the right foot rooted. Extend the left leg up to the sky. Staying here for a few breaths, really press into the earth with the right leg. Press up towards the ceiling with the left. Feel that strength. Breathe so you've got a strong connection. Exhale, bend the left knee. Hook your ankle over the thigh. Get that traction by pressing the left knee forward and down. Breathing into the space you've created in this pose. Keep rooting down through the right foot. Three more breaths. Inhale, re-extend the left leg. Exhale, lower the left foot down to the mat. Press down through both feet. Remove your prop. Two more breaths in your bridge pose. Lifting through your hips, pressing down through the feet. And then exhale, tuck tailbone. Slowly roll upper, mid, and low spine down to the earth. From here, release the back body, either pressing the thighs away or hugging the knees into your chest. If it feels good, you can get a little rocking action side to side, massaging the spine. Then roll over onto your left side. And press your way up to a seat. Coming all the way forward onto forearms and knees, setting up for our dolphin. Those of you familiar with dolphin, just pop right into it. Otherwise, keep the forearms, you can listen to me and we can guide ourselves into this together. So grabbing hold of the opposite upper arm, just to measure the distance between the elbows, and then place the forearms back on the mat, parallel to one another, or for extra support, hands are clasped. Huge breath into the back of the heart. Awesome, Christina. Curl your toes under, hips extend to the sky for dolphin. Connect into that strong breath, really pressing down through the forearms, lifting up to the hips. And then maybe tiptoe the toes in a little bit closer. Yes, awesome, nice, David. Hips extending higher towards the sky so you feel that core engagement. Beautiful, Lisa. Keep the breath strong, supporting you here. Head hips heavy towards the ground. Three more breaths. Maybe coming up onto the tippy toes or the pads of the toes. Exhale, lower your knees to the earth. Press up to the palms of your hands. Working with flash prep. So the right forearm comes down to the ground. Left hand directly underneath the shoulder. And then scoot that left hand back as if it was on a track on the mat, straight back towards the thigh. Hug the left elbow in, so you've got a 90 degree angle here. Press down to the forearm, curl your toes under, lift up into flash prep, yeah. Shift more of the weight into your left hand. So you're gonna naturally wanna sink the weight to that right arm, but shift it intentionally into the left hand. Now if you want extra challenge, float the right leg up to the sky. Breathing here, try to balance the weight between the two arms. Keep hugging that left elbow in. Nice, Mikkel. Two more breaths. Exhale, lower the right foot. Come all the way down to your knees. We'll set up for the second side. Left forearm comes down. Right hand comes underneath your shoulder. And then you're going to scoot it back till you get that 90 degree angle. Hug the right elbow in. Curl your toes under. Lift your hips up to the sky. Shift more of the weight into your right hand. Trying to distribute the weight evenly between the arms. And then you have that option to float the left leg up to the sky. Nice, Gina. Spread the toes, reach high for that left leg. Last breath here. Exhale, lower the left foot down. Come all the way to the knees. Child's pose, puppy or embryo pose. Giving your body a rest here. Feeling the earth support you. Connect back into that intention. That dedication to what you need this morning. A few more breaths here. Connect into that strong inhale and exhale. Deep breath in. Exhale to step or hop to the top of your mat. Forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, extending the spine. Exhale to fold it in. Do that twice more. Inhale, spinal extension, reach back through the sit bone, lengthen through the crown of your head. Nice. Exhale, fold it in. Last one, sit bones reach back, crown of your head draws forward. Exhale, fold it in. Then inhale, come all the way up to standing, arms reach overhead, maybe a little back bend here. Exhale, hands to heart center. Flowing here. Re-extend the arms. Exhale, fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, step left foot back, lunge. Lower that left knee down if that feels okay. Inhale, sweep the arms to the sky. Stay here for an extra breath, just settling into your body in this pose. Yes, beautiful. Exhale, lower hands to the mat. Step back, plank pose. You can always skip the vinyasa and go direct into down dog. Otherwise, lower with me slowly, chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Lifting through the heart, exhale, back to downward facing dog. Inhale, step left foot forward, lunge. Lift and open, telescoping the ribs, lengthening through the arms, feeling for space here. Exhale, hands to the mat, forward fold. Inhale, come all the way up to standing, arms reach tall. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, re-extend. So you're going at your own pace, doing what your body needs. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, step right foot back, low lunge. Keep the inhale going, lift and open. Exhale, lower your hands to the earth. Step to plank. Continue that exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, lift the heart, cobra or up dog. Exhale, back to downward facing dog. Nice, gen. Inhale, step right foot forward, lunge. Lift and open, telescoping the ribs. Exhale, hands to the mat, forward fold. Inhale, rise all the way up, arms sweep overhead. Exhale, hands back. Heart center. Adding on, inhale, re-extend. Exhale, fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, step left foot forward, crescent lunge, arms reach to the sky. Tune into your strong legs to support you here. Connecting into your breath. Nice, Melinda, take one more inhale here. Exhale, hands to the earth, forward fold. Inhale, come all the way upright, arms reach tall. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, re-extend. Exhale, fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, right foot back, crescent lunge. Flowing here, open it up. Exhale, hands to mat, step to plank. Continue through your vinyasa, slow and controlled. Lift and open, downward facing dog. Inhale, step right foot forward, crescent lunge, open it up. Exhale, hands to mat, forward folds. Drive into the belly, come all the way up, reaching tall. Exhale, hands to heart center. One more variation here, inhale, re-extend. Exhale, fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, step left foot back, this time twisty lunge. So keep the left hand on the ground, reach the right arm up to the sky. Hanging out here for a few breaths, lifting. Yeah, beautiful. Creating space. Exhale, right hand to the mat, step to plank. Flow through your vinyasa. Come all the way back and downward facing dog. Inhale, left foot forward, twisting lunge. Right hand stays rooted, lift and open through the left arm. Staying here for a few breaths, connecting to your core. Exhale, lower the left hand down, forward fold. Inhale, come all the way upright, extending through the arms, maybe that back bend. Exhale, hands to heart. Last flow here, inhale, re-extend. Exhale, fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, step right foot back, twisting lunge, lift and open through the left arm. Exhale, hands to mat, step to plank. Flow through your vinyasa. Exhale, back to downward facing dog. Inhale, step right foot forward, twisting lunge, open it up. Exhale, right hand to mat. Step forward, forward fold. Inhale, come all the way up, arms reach tall. Exhale, hands to heart center. Close your eyes. Let's take a moment. Mountain pose. Connecting back to your breath. Connecting deeper into that dedication and intention for yourself this morning. Inhale, float the arms up to the sky. Exhale, sit back, chair pose, Uttanasana. You're always welcome to bend the elbows or reach the arms behind you. If you want to do it true Forrest style, peel the toes away from the mat. Notice how that shifts the weight more into your heels, feels that connection. Bless. Exhale, hands to your thighs. Come up out of the bend, so it's just a soft bend in the knees. Working with Uddiyana Bandha here, so take a deep breath in. Exhale all the air out. Hold empty, draw navel in towards spine, hollowing out the belly. When you're ready, inhale, release the belly, take a deep breath in. We're gonna do that twice more. Exhale all the air out. Hold empty, draw belly in and up. When you're ready to inhale, release the belly, then take a breath in. Do that once more at your own pace. Shake your head a little yes and no, releasing some of that tension. And uncross the arms. Inhale, halfway lift, extending the spine. Exhale, plant your hand on the mat, step your way back. Hang out here. Connect into your core. Press back through the heels, drop forward through the crown of your head. So you're creating this long line of energy through the spine. All right, from here you have a few options. You can bring the knees down to the ground. You can go directly up and back to down dog, or you can flow slow and controlled through this vinyasa. So if you're working the slow and controlled, lower slowly down. Inhale, scoop the chest, cobra or up dog. Exhale, back to downward facing dog. Between the two of you. So funny. Alright. Downward facing dog. Or if you're Adam, you're still lowering the chaturanga. We'll eventually all end up in the downward facing dog.
I love it.
Take a deep breath in, down dog. Exhale, out the mouth. Yeah, let's do that once more. Deep breath in. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, extend the left leg up to the sky. Good. Spread the toes. Reach that leg long like you're trying to press the foot into the diagonal of the ceiling, that corner of the room. Exhale, bend that left knee, open up a little more through the hip, and then shift the weight more into your left hand. So that twist is coming from the mid-spine. Inhale, re-extend the left leg. Exhale, left knee towards outer edge of left arm. Yeah. Inhale, re-extend the left leg. Exhale, left knee crosses over to outer edge of right arm. Inhale, re-extend the left leg. Exhale, knee to chest. Lift up in between the shoulder blades, then set your foot down softly. We're going to rise up, warrior two. So back heel roots, inhale, windmill your arms up, coming into your warrior two. Take a moment, feel into this pose, really pressing into the earth with your feet. And then lifting through your chest, softening through the shoulders. Close your eyes for a moment. Notice how your balance shifts. Tune back into that dedication. So how can you hold this pose, this basic warrior two, in a way that works with your dedication to yourself this morning? Eagle warrior two. On your exhale, wrap the left arm underneath the right. Get that second clasp through the palms of your hands if it's available. Elbows come up in line with the shoulders. Light press of the forearms forward. Breathe into the back of the heart. You may want to lift the arms a little bit higher and rest the forehead on that right bicep. Breathing into the back of your heart. Lift the head up if it's not already. Inhale, open the arms back up. Exhale, reverse warrior. So left palm flips. Exhale, reach up and back, opening through this left side body. Right hand can come to your hip, can work its way down the leg, or if you like that bind, you're welcome to take that version. Breathing here, creating space, especially in this left side body. Moving into a neck stretch, bring just the left arm towards the front of the room. Reach strongly through the left fingertips, and then let the head hang towards towards the right shoulder. Breathe into this left side of the neck, all the way down to the left arm. Reach through that left hand, come back upright for warrior two, and all the way forward into extended warrior, bringing the left forearm down. We'll start with this heart opener, right hand reaches straight up to the sky. Draw the right shoulder blade back, lifting through your chest. Yeah, beautiful. Keep pressing the left arm into left thigh, lifting through the heart. You're welcome to stay here, or you can come into the variation, grabbing hold of the inside of the thigh, or come into that bind, clasping the hands underneath the left leg. About four more breaths wherever you are. Still opening through the right shoulder. Yeah, nice and tall. Creating space. Release through the arms, come all the way back, upright warrior two. Straighten out the left leg. You may want to shorten the stance for a triangle pose. Shift that right hip back, left hand comes forward and down, right arm extends up to the sky. So left hand can be on your shin, a block, or the earth. Drawing that right shoulder blade towards the spine, breathing through. Yeah, a block is a great tool in this pose. Reach through the right hand, come all the way back upright. Exhale, bend the left knee, reach the arms back behind you, interlace the fingers. Lift up through the chest. Exhale, dive forward into ostrich pose. If this bothers your shoulders, you can always release the clasp. But really getting a little bit deeper into the hips here, intentionally moving towards a sensation. Yeah, let the head hang heavy. Hands can always be on the blocks as well. Lower your clasp, then release your hands if they're not already. Head to ankle prep. Walk the right hand towards the back of your mat. Left hand comes to the inside of the left thigh. Start to press that left thigh forward and away. Lean towards the right leg. So your torso is reaching towards the right leg. The only thing that's shifting forward is the left knee. Yeah, breathe into this. Right hand can always be on a block. Exhale, release. Turn the left toes in so your inner edges of your feet are parallel. Shifting into Prasarita Padottanasana, this wide-legged forward folds. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale to fold it in, just letting the torso hang. You can do anything you'd like with your arms here. Yeah, you can always clasp hands behind you. You can grab the big toes. Simply let the hands rest on the mat. Really, whatever is appealing to you in this moment. We'll take about five more breaths here. Release your hands. Take the left hand and find the right shin or outer edge of your foot. From here, the right hand can come back behind you or just simply on the right hip. And then start to twist open, yeah, towards the back of your mat. You can draw that left elbow down to help pull your way kindly deeper into this twist. We'll take two more breaths. Inhale, re-extend the right arm. Exhale, release both hands.
Inhale, halfway lift. Walk your hands to the top of your mat. Spin your feet around. So your back heel's lifted, you're in this low lunge. Back knee can come down for support. Right hand stays on the ground or a block, moving into your spinal twist. Left arm floats to the sky. If that bothers the shoulder, left hand can always be on the thigh instead. Yeah, beautiful. Twist into this window side of the room, opening up with each breath. Full, complete breaths, filling yourself up. Exhale, lower the left hand down. Fire up the legs, inhale, rise all the way up. Crescent lunge. Option to bend your elbows and lift more open through the chest and the front body. Breathing here, creating that space once again. We extend the arms. Exhale, hands all the way down to the mat. Lower the right knee to the ground. Add some padding if you'd like under that knee. You can always just flip over the mat for support. Hands come onto this left thigh, moving a little bit deeper into the stretch. Inch the left foot forward. Shift your hips forward. Start to breathe into this stretch. If you don't feel much here, you can always walk the foot more forward. Lift the chest more to the sky. If you want a little more challenge, one, bless you, or both arms can reach the sky here. Three more breaths. Last inhale here. Exhale, hands all the way down to the earth. Shift your hips back so they're square. Stacked over that right knee. Straighten out the left. You may want to place your hands on blocks if that ground feels far away. Breathing into the left hamstrings. Breathing into the calf. And adjust the positioning of your foot to transition the stretch to different places. A few more full breaths here. Exhale, bend the left knee, walk your hands forward. Curl the back toes under. Step your way back to plank pose. Your choice, you can go directly to down dog or flow through that vinyasa. Chaturanga, inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, back to downward. Take a deep breath in here. Exhale out the mouth. Let's do one more like that. Deep breath in. Exhale, let it go. Inhale to float the right leg up to the sky. Reach long to that leg as you press into the earth with your hands. Exhale, bend the right knee. Start to open up through your hip here. Knee floating higher to the sky. Shift more of the weight into your right hand so you feel that mid-body twist. Inhale, re-extend the right leg. Exhale, right into outer of the right arm. Inhale, re-extend. Exhale, a little cross-body crunch, right knee to outer edge of left arm. Inhale, re-extend. Exhale, knee to chest. Hug up to the upper back, connect into your core. Then set that foot down softly. Rising up, warrior two. See if I can remember this whole sequence on the second side. Arms parallel to the ground, just taking a moment, just connecting into your strong legs, balancing the weight evenly between the right and left. Close your eyes. balance is really this constant shift. Opening your eyes, wrap the right arm underneath the left, moving into Eagle Warrior Two. Elbows come up in line with the shoulders. Relax the shoulder blades down the spine. Breathe into the back of your heart. It can be a soft press forward. Your forehead is down on the bicep, lift your head back up. Inhale, re-extend the arms, opening up. Exhale into reverse warrior, right palm flips to the sky. Exhale, reach up and back, opening through the side body, yeah. Left hand can be on your hip or maybe work its way down the leg or take that bind. Breathing into this right side body. Very intentionally creating space. Moving into the next stretch, reach the right arm forward, parallel to the ground, let the head hang towards that back shoulder. Breathing into the side of the neck. Really trying to unwind some of the tension in the neck and shoulder. Reach through the right hand, come all the way up. Bring the right forearm all the way down to the thigh, setting up for this side angle pose. Left hand reaches straight up to the sky, opening through the heart to start. Yeah, beautiful. Breathing here from the chest out to the fingertips. Yeah, beautiful, David. Option to stay here or come into that variation, wrapping the left arm behind the back, and or coming all the way into the bind, clasping hands behind the right leg. Breathing here, feeling the ground support you as you open through the chest, two more breaths. You have the bind release, root down strongly through your feet, come all the way back up, warrior two. Straighten out the right leg for triangle pose. You want to shorten the stance a bit. Right hand reaches as far forward as you can and down. Left arm extends back up to the sky. If this bothers your shoulder, you can always bring the left hand to the hip instead. Fill this pose up with breath. Perhaps closing your eyes here, drawing that attention even more inward. Awesome breathing. Keep yourself focused on sensation, focused on breath. Reach through the left hand, come all the way back up, warrior two. Bend into the right knee, release the arms behind you. Clasp the hands, lift up through the chest. Exhale into ostrich pose. Torso comes to the inside of the legs, folding down. Let the head hang heavy, maybe shaking a little yes and no, side to side. Breathing all the way down into your hips here, two more breaths. Lower the clasp, then release your hands. Head to ankle prep, left hand comes towards the back foot, so towards the left foot. Right hand comes to the inside of the right thigh. Start to press that right thigh forward towards the front of your mat and away, and then lean the rest of your body towards the left leg. Yeah, beautiful. The deeper you bend into that right knee, the more you will feel this stretch. Release. Spin those right toes around so the inner edges are parallel. Inner edges of your feet, rather, are parallel. Inhale, halfway lift, extending the spine. Exhale, Fold it in, cross Rita Padottanasana, this wide-legged forward fold. Whatever you'd like with your arms here, you can take the same version that you took on the other side, or perhaps taking a different version here. Five deep breaths. Where can you release a layer of unnecessary tension? Reach back with the right hand, grab hold of the left ankle, foot, shin with that right hand. Take the left arm up to the sky, and then wrap that left arm behind your back, opening into this twist. Yeah, that's it. If that's too much, you can always keep the left hand on the hip. Open the left shoulder up so you're twisting towards the back of the room. Yeah, beautiful. Two more breaths. Inhale, re-extend the left leg. Exhale, release both hands to the earth. Inhale, halfway lift, spinal extension. And then walk your hands to the top of your mat, swiveling the feet around. Spinal twist, left hand stays on the ground. Inhale, right arm opens up to the sky. Yeah, if this bothers your shoulder, you can always keep the hand on the thigh rather than extending the arm. You can always place the left hand on a prop rather than the ground. With the bottom of each exhale here, connect into that Uddiyana Bandha, that lower abdominal connection. With each inhale, feel for more expansion, more space. Exhale, lower the right hand down. Fire up the lunge, inhale, come all the way upright, press and lunge. Core is strong, legs are strong, lift the chest. You always have that option to bend the elbows, turning this more into a heart opener. Breathing into the front body, two more breaths. Inhale, re-extend the arms if the elbows are bent. Exhale, hands all the way down to the mat. Lower the left knee to the earth, adding padding in here. Hands come up to this left thigh. Start to inch that left foot forward, moving deeper into this stretch. Lift through the chest, press back through the left leg. You have that option to extend one or both arms. The more you shift the hips forward, the more you will feel the stretch. Last inhale here, lift the heart. Exhale, hands come down to the ground, framing the front foot. Shift your hips back so they're stacked over the left knee, straighten out the right leg for this half. If the ground feels far away, use a block. Breathe into the right hamstrings. Maybe you get a nice stretch to the calf here as well. Can you soften through the shoulders and jaw? Bend the right knee, walk your hands forward, step back to plank pose, that upper push-up position. From here, you can go direct into down dog or flow through that vinyasa, moving at your own pace. We'll all meet up in downward facing dog. Take a deep breath in and down dog. Exhale, lower your knees to the earth. Take a seat on your mat for a moment. So we gotta do one fun thing today. So playing around a little bit with Tiddhasana, seeing what will happen. So, into a version of it together. So real quick, come into a squat. And you can always place a block underneath your sit bones just for support so you're not sitting in the knee joints. From here, the arms are going to come under the legs, back behind. So I like to hook the heel in between this L of the pointer finger and the thumb. And this may be where you work, is just getting that stretch through the hips. Maybe you start to walk the feet forward, and you're going to bend the elbows enough so you're like sitting on the arms. So you create the shelf of your joints. This can be where you stay. Maybe the feet can come up and touch and do a little dance. Or maybe one leg will extend out, or maybe both legs will extend out. For the full pose, the arms actually straighten, the legs reach up, and you might fall over like that. Any questions? This is just all about play. Let's see what happens. You all look so excited. So glad we're playing. Okay, so come into your squat. Once again, you can place a block under your hips, and that can be where you work. Or take the hands, wrap them behind the legs, create that L shape. And then you have to bend the elbows enough that you can just sit the legs on the arms. You may need to adjust the hands so you can get there. Yeah, and then maybe one or both feet can lift up. Maybe one or both legs can extend outward. Breathe. Yeah. See, you guys are all in a version of the pose. It's awesome. Nice. Yeah. Sweet. And you can just sit on the block. That's a perfectly good place. Once you're done playing around, you're just going to come into a baddha konasana. Fun, right? Just kidding. All right. Feet together, just fold forward. Take a few breaths here. Not worrying about any of that because none of it actually matters. It's just because it's sometimes fun to see how you can contort your body in a yoga class. Take a few deep breaths down into the low back, down into the hips. Head hangs heavy, three more breaths here. Switch sides at your own pace, hooking the right ankle over the left thigh, hugging that left knee in as you press the right knee away.
yourself here.